The texture fill tool is a vector-based method for filling backgrounds with complex, irregular details whilst minimizing tool movements performed by the machine. For example, it is a useful tool when we want to create a distinctive appearance and/or an interesting tactile feel. What distinguishes texture fill from other tooling operations is the division of tool movements into segments. By varying the segments in terms of length, overlap, angle, etc., we can create interesting patterns. For this example design, we want to use texture fill to create an interesting background for the text. Notice how this design has been broken down into distinct regions so that we can apply different toolpath operations. For the text, we will apply a 3D chisel toolpath, and this button will automatically calculate the maximum depth that is required to produce a nice carved effect for the text. For the swoosh below the text, we also apply a 3D chisel toolpath, except we manually set a more shallow depth that seemed appropriate for the design. For the border shape, we selected only the narrow portions and then applied an online toolpath, again setting a depth that seemed appropriate. Outside the border shape, we applied a fill toolpath to clear away material from around the sign. For the remaining area, we want to provide some texture, so from the engrave menu, we choose Create Toolpath, Texture Fill. Your choice of tool depends upon the material and the desired texture. As a suggestion, a bull nose tool tends to produce good results, as will a V-bit or engraving bit. There are several fill styles available. Of these styles, the hatch fill will generally produce the cleanest result because the tooling operations are simple back and forth motions, which you can then vary by adjusting the following options that are presented here in the texture fill dialog. The edge offset will be from the edge of the containing object. The angle will rotate the tooling operations. Line spacing is the distance between adjacent tooling operations. Note that you can vary the spacing in terms of an overall percentage. For each segment, set the minimum and maximum length that can occur. The length of the segments will vary randomly, though constrained by what you set. The start and end points of each segment will generally advance across the material. The cut overlap will cause the end of a segment to overlap the subsequent segment, causing the segments to blend together. The overlap varies as a percentage of the segment length, though you can also randomly vary the amount of overlap. The cutting depth of the segments will also vary. Use these fields to set limits on how deep the tool will plunge into the material. After completing our texture fill operation, we preview the result by using View Menu, Show 3D. And seen here is the same job when output to a sheet of signboard material.